Penguin Random House Audio presents There's No Manual, Honest and Gory Wisdom About Having a Baby. Written and read by Beth Newell and Jackie Ann Ruiz.
Publisher's note. This audiobook includes a bonus PDF of illustrations done by Jackie, which can be viewed on any PC or Mac computer. To the pile of moms who always provide. Introduction. New moms and pregnant women are bombarded with unsolicited advice from every direction. We hear it from our family, friends, coworkers, the internet, and that unhappy-looking woman in our apartment building who keeps telling us to put a hat on the baby before he catches a cold. In August. With so much conflicting advice, it's hard to know who to listen to. Here's our advice. Fuck advice.
There's no real manual for motherhood, except this one.
Other books will tell you how to make your ascent into motherhood a streamlined, predictable process of nap time, sleep training, and feeding schedules. Not only is it impossible to live up to all that advice, but surrounding ourselves with a series of boxes to check gives women an entirely misleading idea of what's in store for them. The reality of bringing life into the world involves exhaustion, pain, tears, and so much milk spilled, splattered, and spewed all over everything you own. And there are moments when you're awake in the middle of the night, tiredly nursing your baby while you Google photos of newborn rash, that you feel totally helpless and alone, in spite of all your preparation and research.
But you also get to be a literal goddess, capable of creating human life, which is pretty cool. No one talks much about that part either.
This having a baby thing is hard, and not in the ha-ha, diapers are really stinky, oh boy, I'm not ready to be a father way you've seen portrayed in the movies. Like, really hard, in a gut-twisting, bone-shifting, perineal-tearing way that is impossible to fully convey to anyone who hasn't crawled through the baby trenches. It's hard enough as it is down here in the shit. Don't add to that stress by trying to perform motherhood to other people's standards and regimens. Instead, focus on survival and laughter. That's what we're aiming to help you with in this book. Don't get us wrong, many of those other parenting books are filled with gems of wisdom, but we want to cut the BS and give it to you straight, the way your best friend would. We're here to tell you that those early days of parenting might include as much sobbing into a pillow about your boobs and the fact that your husband doesn't have any, as it does staring lovingly at your newborn. That's normal.
And it's normal to have pregnancy and baby problems that bear no resemblance to your friend's pregnancy and baby problems. It's also normal to confuse your baby's first fetal movements with fart bubbles. And it's normal to confuse your early contractions with bad gas. A lot of this mom stuff is confusing and farty, but don't worry. You'll get through this. We wrote this book while our babies were letting out some pretty distracting ass burps. Please forgive the tubos. We can do anything. Women are fucking magic.
Apologies in advance. This book is meant to help you get through all the difficulties of having a baby, but it will not do justice to what some go through. That group includes, but is not limited to, single mothers, mothers of color, women undergoing in vitro fertilization, adoptive parents, surrogates, trans men carrying babies, mothers carrying multiples, and mothers suffering miscarriages or other health issues. We wanted to speak to the common burdens of pregnancy and childbirth, which we felt were not being fully represented in popular literature. We hope you get something out of this and that somewhere a tired mom is finding a way to speak to the issues we were unable to cover. We see you and we support you.
One more note before we begin. This book is divided up into sections, but we recommend reading it all at once. You may think now, I'll read that part once the baby arrives, but trust us, you won't. You'll be too tired. There's lots of stuff that'll be easier to emotionally and physically prepare for in advance rather than in the moment. You won't need all this info, but we want you to make the most of what's helpful. You can always skim now and refer back later. You got this.
A brief history of birth until now.
On our journey to try to tell you everything that everyone forgot to tell you about having a kid, We may as well start at the beginning of human procreation with a brief history of how women have been making life with their bodies.
160,000 BC. A Homo erectus woman births the first Homo sapiens baby. While she doesn't have the language or ability to recognize his larger brain, she does note to herself that, fuck, this head is huge, and this one seems needy. Evolution charts will later write women out of the story of evolution, depicting man's emergence as a feat unto himself, with hairy apes and men striding confidently across time into existence, their tired cave wives forgotten.
160,000 BC to 320 BC. Women continue to make humanity happen, largely unnoticed, while men make large sculptures of their dicks and other dick-like objects.
320 BC. The first known cesarean section is performed in the birth of Indian Emperor Bindusara. Concerned parties immediately question whether the baby's survival was, quote, natural enough.
Zero-ish. Mary wants to have a home birth, but is thwarted by societal pressures.
1500s to 1800s. Men start to enter the field of midwifery in order to show women how they've been doing it wrong. They began helping with painful medical advances, including episiotomies and forceps.
1865. Life-saving baby formula is invented by a German dude. Women are immediately shamed for using it.
1881. Nitrous oxide, or laughing gas, is used for the first time to treat labor pain. The United States quickly disregards this effective, controllable, and non-invasive treatment, deciding that it is better suited to countries where women's health and well-being are a higher priority.
1900s. Medical schools changed the name of midwifery to obstetrics because it sounds smarter and less girly.
1909. Epidurals are introduced as a pain relief option during labor, with women immediately questioning whether they deserve them.
1914. Doctors introduce medicated twilight sleep to give mothers the gift of having no memory of meeting their babies.
1950s. With the rising quality of life, more and more women gain the freedom to focus on being moms 24/7.
1970s. Ina Mae Gaskin begins a new natural birth movement, which quickly turns into a way for women to judge one another while we navigate the mess that men have made.
1996 to 2010. C-section rates rise dramatically because OBs want to get home to watch The Sopranos.
2020. This book is published. Everything is fixed. Women will never judge one another for making decisions based off their own individual circumstances again.
Section 1. When a baby is in you.
Weird symptoms that might mean you're pregnant. So, to start off, congrats, you're pregnant. Or are you? Because pregnancy is like nothing else your body has done, all of the symptoms are very weird and vague. Here's what the early stage might feel like. You've been barfing a bit, or more than a bit. Some women don't barf, and some women do it all day, every day. But any amount of regular vomiting is terrible. So if that's happening to you, we're here to say fuck that in your honor, and also congrats on being pregnant. Talk to your healthcare provider if nausea is severe. You're hungry and want to barf? Do you feel nauseous or hungry or a strange combination of both? Are you violently craving a hamburger just minutes after retching over the toilet? Is there a vague feeling of badness that haunts your digestive system? Anything weird regarding your appetite is a possible symptom of pregnancy. Everything smells and tastes very, very bad. The smell and taste of certain things may make you want to crawl out of your own skin. This heightened sensitivity of your body's lizard brain is trying to save you from eating poisony stuff. Things you've always found gross, like your partner's morning breath, might make you gag. And formerly innocuous favorites, like seafood or Cheetos, will suddenly seem rancid. You may also find yourself asking, is something burning? When someone lights a match two blocks away. Avoid what you can and try to appreciate your superhuman abilities despite picking up the distinct floral bouquet of every stranger's BO. You have cramps, but not period cramps. Experiencing some intense cramping at the wrong time of the month? These wake-you-up-in-the-night pains could be the first signs of an embryo burrowing into your uterine lining. Yup, it's weird, and you're feeling it. You're spotting spotting. I spy with my little eye something that is light bleeding that ranges from pink to red to brown. Is a mystery unfolding in your undies? This is just your first taste of the coming grossness of pregnancy. You're drooling? Are you walking around like an excited dog?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.